The Supreme Court upheld the individual mandate in the Affordable Care Act on the grounds that it represented a constitutional tax that the Congress has the right to impose, and not on the grounds that it was within congressional authority under the Commerce Clause, which was a bit of a surprise. One of the main ways the Affordable Care Act seeks to expand insurance coverage here in the United States is through a dramatic expansion of the Medicaid program. As of 2014, another 18 to 20 million individuals presumably would be on Medicaid. Under the court's ruling today, the states have the option of not going ahead with that portion of the Affordable Care Act, with the Medicaid expansion, if they choose not to do so. And one of the interesting questions will be whether or not a Governor Scott in Florida or a Perry in Texas, et cetera, decides that they're not going to implement the Medicaid expansion, even though by doing so, they would forego between 90 and 100% federal funding for those expansions. Those provisions of the Affordable Care Act that have already begun to be implemented, enabling certain Americans to get expanded health insurance coverage, i.e. young adults up to the age of 26 and children who have pre-existing conditions, those expansions will continue without interruption. Over the next couple of years, since the rest of the bill and the heart of the bill isn't really going to be implemented until 2014, over the next couple of years, Congress and the states and regulators at the state and federal level and providers and hospitals, et cetera, will continue the implementation efforts.